let's contrast and compare a little bit here. What I find interesting is that there's the game industry, where we see that a lot because there's a lot of games out there. And there's sort of computer-aided design, which is sort of a different kind of a graphics, different kind of a 3D computer graphics way of doing things. So, well, for starters, what would you say is the biggest difference between sort of games programming and computer-aided design programming?
I think the end result is the big difference in that if you're playing a game and something happens with the visuals, you know, a frame or two goes off, the worst that happens is your avatar dies. If you mess up in a computer-aided design package, people can die. It's just that there's much more, I think I'm much more invested in AutoCAD because of the importance of the work that it does.
Well, with game design, it's kind of a limited field in a sense, in that they're in total control of the product and there's a whole team working on that. Your product is different in the sense that you're selling to people and they're using it for who knows what. Can you tell us some of the differences there?
Well, like I said, in games, the world and the behavior is fairly static. The things happen and things can move around and change, but in general, like you said, there's a lot of control that the game designers, the game programmers have over what's going on in the game. Whereas with the CAD system, our users can do pretty much anything. And an interesting thing is that CAD systems are, you can view it as a way of creating content. So people can actually write games using a CAD system to design the assets for the game and then play the game. So they can almost interact with each other that way. Right. But you need a lot more flexibility within the CAD package or whatever package you're using to design the assets for the game. Once you get it in the game, there are a lot of tricks that programmers play and artists in order to fake things out and sort of get what you need done. Again, you can also deal with the fact that if you're a little bit off one frame, it won't really matter because the action is moving quickly enough that you'll get right past it.
Right. I mean, just the fact that there's a reality to, you know, whatever you're building makes sense that there's, you know, AutoCAD and so on really has sort of different kinds of constraints. Well, with that, for example, I mean, are there constraints as far as precision or elements like that?
Oh, definitely. We have to deal with things like, we have this one model that we use internally for a lot of testing, which is a model of the solar system. So we have to have AutoCAD be able to go all the way from looking at the entire solar system down to looking at a plaque on the moon that was left by Neil Armstrong. And we need to be able to read the lettering on that plaque. So there's the range of precision that we have to deal with can really blow away a lot of the graphics hardware. So again, there's some tricks you have to play in order to be able to handle all that different resolution with only single precision floating point.
Yeah, very good.
The nice thing is when we're dealing with when we had our software implementation, of course we had double precision, we could deal with it much better, but when your end result really requires single precision, that's where it gets tricky.